Yeah, so we travelled across when the weather was rubbish from the Torridon area yesterday, eh? And
it wasn't rubbish, Paul. Don't be so negative. It was...
I'm just a realist, Adam.
Interesting. It was interesting weather. Like it is now.
Yeah, like very, it is now.
Very interesting. And, I mean, it's very windy. It's atmospheric.
Is that what you call it?
I don't like to be negative.
So we're just kind of waiting it out to see really what happens. I mean, the weather apps are telling us it's going to clear up, so...
That's why I don't download weather apps, because they're all bloody useless.
Yeah.
Well, especially a place like here, because you're so... You're right on the coast, so you can't... And you've got mountains, and it's very unpredictable, I think.
Yeah, definitely. And it was clear. It was clear first thing this morning, and then all of a sudden...
You can probably hear the rain now. Yeah, it's just bucketing down.
So we've come to... we're on the Isle of Skye now. And we've just come to a place called the Fairy Glen, because we haven't checked it out before. So that was the intention anyway.
And the reason why we came to the Fairy Glen is because we figured that weather was going to be somewhat nasty. And I think, I could be wrong, but most of the photography locations that I know about tend to be the grand landscape. So, and of course, if it's pouring rain, you've got the grand landscape, then probably not going to be that great. Although you can get some light beams coming through, and
yeah.
But anyway,
interesting weather conditions, I guess.
Yeah, very interesting.
But with this sort of place, I guess you don't really need too much of the rest of the landscape in, eh?
Well,
it's got one focal point, really, which is that main sort of rocky outcrop.
Yeah, I think the only problem with this type of weather is that if there's no texture in the clouds, if it's just white sky, then it's, and you're shooting up at it, then it's there's not much you can do about it.
No,
so, I mean, maybe with a drone, if you're allowed to use a drone here and you're looking somewhat more down on it rather than up, that might work. But I'm not flying my drone in this weather. It's just absolutely pelting down.
I think maybe the best thing we can do is stick the kettle on, mate, I think.
I think so. Paul's had some problems with his popped up. Is that it's been raining pretty much every day, and drying it out is a bit of a problem. It's starting to soak into the mattress.
Yeah, so. It's a bit soggy.
But, you know, I mean... Like, Scotland is very similar to Vancouver Island this time of year. It's just absolutely miserable. And it's good because it, on the island anyway, it supplements all the reservoirs and such. But, yeah, I mean, it's just that time of year, isn't it? So you've got to kind of take what comes your way.
Well, it's not called a misty isle for nothing.
No, and it's very misty in your van right now.
So we'll go and get the kettle on and we'll catch up with you in a bit. So we've taken the opportunity to dive out while there was a bit of a break in the weather and come up to where this spire is that's overlooking the Fairy Glen. And to be quite honest, I'm not really sure about it, especially from this angle. There's a little lock down in the bottom there which looks quite nice, and it would probably work really well with reflections. But as it is now, the light's really flat. We've got no light at all. And yeah, I'm not particularly inspired really. I think I might try walking around to the far side of the spire and seeing if there's more of a shot there. But as it is at the minute, I haven't really noticed anything that really catches my eye and makes me want to stop and take a shot. So moving around to this side seems to have helped really quite a lot, because we're getting some nice directional light just hitting the side of the pinnacle over there. And that's kind of really, really made the shot. When I was further across down where I was, it kind of lost. It got itself lost against the rest of the landscape. But coming back here and shooting towards basically the coast direction, it stands out a lot more and you've got a lot more going on. So when the light hit, we managed to grab a shot, and if it turned out, I'll pop it up now. Yeah, so we decided we'd come up to the Kerang just to check it out, just to see what it was like, because last time we were here, it was socked in, wasn't it? We couldn't see a thing because of the rain. But tonight, we didn't think it was going to catch any light because it's generally a sunrise location, or you seem to think, eh?
I'm such an idiot. I didn't bring my camera because I thought, it's all been photographed before and, you know, it's a morning shot and anyway, blah, blah, blah. So we came for a walk and... Well, anyway,
yeah.
The light was quite spectacular, actually, especially on this pinnacle.
Yeah, it was lovely.
So we walked down the trail, and Paul had his camera, and he's gloating, and
miserable.
Now I'm moping around because I took some phone shots, but it's not quite the same. Anyway, I'm happy for Paul.
Well, with any luck, I think I might have got a couple of decent shots out of it. Anyway.
Well, you should have. I mean, the light was spectacular.
Yeah, it was lovely.
Even now, the clouds are lighting up, and it's really quite something. Look, it's still catching light.
Yeah,
this thing.
I mean, we must have been here about 15 minutes, and it's still catching light on the top of it.
I don't know why I didn't bring my camera.
Still plenty of light in front of us as well.
Yeah, the cliffs behind us. So, you know, I mean, I thought this was a morning shot, morning area, and I think it is. But in the evening, this time of year, anyway, the sun comes down through that valley there. And it's quite spectacular. So, lesson learned.
Yeah, definitely. It's a massive, lovely glow behind us.
It's brilliant. And there's no one here now. There's no photographers.
Everybody's left. Somebody walked past us with a wedding dress on. She looked freezing. Anyway, if this shot's turned out, I'll pop it up now. So I'm just heading down to the ferry terminal to drop Adam off for a few days. I think you're going to Harrison Lewis to check that out with Alistair for a few days. And then I'll be coming back up to pick you up again and head back off into Torridon, maybe later in the week and maybe a couple of days here when I first pick you up, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, it's beautiful here and it seems a shame to come all this way and not take some shots here. So.
And definitely after 10 days of rain, now look at it. Of course, I'm going home, aren't I? That's called Sod's Law, that is.
Sod's Law.
So I'll see you in about 4 days' time, eh, mate?
All right, see you later.
See you later, take care. Well, good morning and welcome back to the Scottish Highlands again. As you'll have seen last time, When I left Adam, I left him at Uig Ferry Terminal, and I got as far down as the Green Welly stop in Tyndrum, and my van packed in. It wasn't the best experience ever. I had to get three different recovery wagons to get home. Luckily, however, when I got back home, I managed to get it fixed, and it was just a simple fix. It was just an intercooler, so it was just a new intercooler, and I'm back on the road.